This past Friday, teams voted 28-1-1 in favor of new lottery rules to be implemented for the 2019 draft. The reform will see the top three teams having equal odds of obtaining the first pick and increase odds for teams 5 through 10. I've got our experts, Dom Vernazza, Ennis Warlick here. We're going to break it down. Dom, do you think the lottery is good or bad for the league?
I don't really like it. I think it was a little too reactionary to really just one team, the 76ers, and what they were doing. Mm-hmm. I think 25% is a good number, what they had, because it still gives you a better chance if you're the worst team.
The
if
top
you
three teams have 14% chance even.
That, to me, just seems way too low. Mm-hmm. You know, I feel like bad teams, these worst teams, are going to get stuck in a cycle where they can't get these better players.
What I'm going to say is I think from a fan perspective, this was a good thing. And I think we're not completely done with it, but I think we're starting to gravitate to an era where we're not going to see teams putting out awful lineups every time.
We'll see.
So going off of that, Ennis, do you think that this is going to reduce tanking?
I think we can both agree that tanking isn't completely solved.
I don't think it ever will be.
I don't think tanking will ever be completely solved. But again, getting back to my other point, I think we're starting to gravitate more towards an era where we're not going to see as much.
I don't think in-season tanking is ever going to be stopped. Mm-hmm. I think once you get midway season, you realize you're not making the playoffs, even with less odds. You know, you still might as well lose many games.
Yeah.
But I think it's going to stop the 76ers style. You know, our plan for the next 4 years is to tank. I think that's what
just
they're trying
to
do.
Up on guys over the
I think
years.
That is going to stop.
Okay. So, Dom, do you think that this lottery reform is necessary even then?
No, like I said, they're just reacting to one team. You know, back in before 1993, they had the same odds they do now. Then the Magic won it twice in a row from the last position, and everyone freaked out. The lottery's broken. Let's change it. You know, I wonder how many years till an eight team gets it twice, and, you know, it's broken. Let's give the worst teams better odds.
Here's what I'm going to say to that. I'm going to say that I'm just tired of seeing the same exact teams in the same in the lottery.
Well, it's just been the past few years. I mean, in general, it's a good turnaround.
But it hasn't been the same.
So how would you feel, though, if completely, like, the second to bottom team, they don't get a good pick for the next 2-3 years. How do you feel about that?
Well, I think
the poor Nets, they just get their picks back and now they're not going to get anyone with them.
I don't know. I still think that this is just the app. I think this was a necessary thing, and I think it's just a necessary evil.
Now that there isn't just an all-out bad team, maybe it won't have as much of an effect in the future.
I mean, I don't think it was a good move. 25, I mean, even if you're the worst team, rarely do you actually win the lottery. I don't think it was necessary.
All right, not necessary. The change in the NBA comes at the change of the month. It's October, and that means MLB playoffs are here. Evan Piercy and Matt Holzapfel join us to go over the top stories. Stay tuned.